Hi folks, welcome back to PGA Tour 15, the PS4. We're currently playing a kind of live tournament against the pros that are playing as we speak at the Arnold Palmer Invitational. We're just about to tee off. There's the updated leaderboard. They're at 314, Kisner and Charlie Hoffman are 10 under. Rory McIlroy's 10 under par through 16. He's 4 under par today. The other guys, Hoffman and that, are 1 over. So we'll just check the weather, which is here. I think it's coming out the northeast and it's about 12 miles per hour. I think I've got the weather actually set up. Yeah, that is there. It's 13 northeast. Right, so that's what we're going to put in. So let's get the game up. 10 to 15 northeast, black tees, pin select Sunday, tournament conditions, time of day will be noon. Right, let's play. Tournament is going on as we speak. It's getting to the closing stages. I want to sort of play this. I need to kind of speed up and hopefully get to the last few holes so that we can kind of play it as it happens. Kind of shot for shot type of thing. So the audio is okay. Anytime you get a chance to play the King's Golf Course in Arnold Palmer, that is a pleasure. Hosted the Arnold Palmer Invitational. Right, let's go. Let's get this going here. Produces a worthy champion. Arnold Palmer bought it in the 1970s through the years, Frank. It wasn't unusual. You can probably just hear the commentary. I don't think I'm going to get any kind of copyright issues or anything. Hoffman's got a putt here for par. He's made it, so he stays at 10 under. He's 10 under par. So we're at 12 under. I'm actually going to hit this with a bit of draw, I think. Oh, that's not a bad tee shot. So the wind's pretty much as it is in the real course. Oh, we're going to catch it off. It's actually went quite good. It's getting quite tight, getting into the final few holes. Right, probably want to let this ride in on the wind. Might actually have to take a bit off it. I think it's going to run quite a bit. I might actually just put that, because that's like an advert. Oh, that's a great shot in. Oh, nearly goes in the hole. What a shot. So we're 12 under par. They started at 11, so we're short in front. And this is probably going to be for a birdie. Come on. Come on. And I guess it's the 13 under par. At that moment in time, we'd have a two-shot lead. I think they went kind of steady for the first few holes. They've actually dropped a couple of, well, two shots. One shot. So they're 1 over par at the moment. And this is probably going to be about a 3-club drop down here, I believe. Just gauging the wind here. It's not bad, just slightly right of target. And it's drifting a little bit, but you can still be quite long. So I was trying to come up with an idea of how to play live. I was actually thinking of teeing off at the first. Teed off, but that would be, I mean, an average round of golf from a pro takes quite a long time, so that would have been a long video. Whoa. So doing this, letting him play ahead, and then trying to catch up with him to play the last couple of holes is probably the best idea. This looks slightly... Yeah, there's a little bit of break in it. Oh, we missed it. Oh, missed it right at target. That was just enough to take that away. Wasn't really a good putt. So I've got the golf on my iPad. I'm recording my computer with my Elgato game system and playing it on the big screen. Oh man, this could go. This is quite dangerous because we can cut quite a bit of this corner. I think we can cut a bit of that. Oh, not had it. Well, I'm actually quite glad we had it with a bit of slice. It's probably going to be a good shot. It's going to find the rough, probably. Yep. Just check my audio. My audio has been cutting out of late, but it seems to be a wee bit more stable now. 115 to the hole. Right. What have we got here in the rough? Not much. The wind's going to take it quite a bit. It's not a bad shot in terms of the hit. Could be a bit short. No, not bad. It's going to give us a birdie putt at least.
Well, this could be a tough one right here, Frank. It's a very long putt, Rich. Obviously, it's difficult, but he still has a chance to save this one for birdie.
I don't like the way it's coming off this hill. They're going to go a bit there. Oh, I mishit that.
You couldn't ask for much more than that, except to make it. Even par, currently.
Hopefully it does break as much as this. Yep.
So just getting started.
Well, it's in for part. Right, McIlroy's teeing off at 18th.
Rich Lerner alongside
sees tee shot here.
Very scoreable. Two bunkers down the left, the first of which takes three.
Yep, right out the middle.
To get it past that.
Definite birdie hole. Maybe even a chance for
oh, that's a difficult shot. You draw this into the wind, I believe. Oh, we've hooked it. We might get away with it if the wind up. I mean, at the moment they are what, 10 under par.
Just trying to make clean
so from the rough. We've got a 2-shot lead at the moment. I don't think we're going to reach this, to be honest. Just try and shove it up the fairway. Picked it again. Miss that tree. I'll get into it. Bit ragged in this hole.
Frank, anything you do differently from the rough in terms of
man,
swing,
6 foot up.
The club a little bit more quickly?
No, I think the wind's going to carry that, if I'm honest.
Because you want the club to be going down. Down, it's got to go down through the
grass. I got a bit short. Oh, that's pretty good. But that perfect probably absolutely bang on.
Coming out of the rough, able to manage the distance and now in great position.
Looks pretty level. And she goes, now above it. Back to 13 under. So remember, we've had rounds of 68, 68, and 68. So three, four under par scores. So we're actually now 13 under. Wind's going to come off that bit nice. Sustain for those trees. Let it drift a bit, although we have had it with a bit of draw again. Should be okay, it's going to cut it out. And that'll do nicely. Mark Leishman's hold a putt, has it? He was 9 under par, so he went to 10 under. Right, what we got here? 51.
The thing you're really looking at right now is just the flag.
I could just put a wee bit more on it. Oh, come on, please. Oh, be good. Get up! Not bad. Oh, which one's went to 11 under par? He's played through 16, he's on the 17th. So he's got a short lead. So McIlroy's actually going to have to get a birdie at the last, which is quite a tricky par 4. Oh, what does this do? It drops off that side. Okay. Maybe just here. Come on. Straight, man. Oh, it's annoying. Yes, I'd rather have a wee bit of break that you can see than just a subtle flat shot. It's especially when it's like 10 foot or so. Frank, this is a big running par 5. Dragonfly. Can be menacing just looking at it from the tee. Oh, the wind's right in our face here. Tempting, reachable for the longer. We just hit it here. Your name's John Daly, who took a whopping 18. So oh, we've had a bit of drop. Oh, this could be nip and tuck. No, we're okay. That's pretty good. It is, but you still not a bad shot into the wind, actually, 300 odd yards. That'll do nicely. Setting up for another approach, our right, 2-2 net. God, look at the wind. Excellent play from earlier in the round. Indeed, there's no better feeling in the world than when you know you're firing on all cylinders. Hitting fairways, yeah, let's go for that. Just going straight at the flag. Right now, everything is working. A wee bit of draw, but it's not a huge amount. Should be okay. Distance is good. Guys over the pin, but they've got an eagle chance. Right, bit of break on it. 3 inches down, so we'll knock that down. I think we'll go to 39, maybe even 38. Much break. And we'll go a bit here. Break a little. Break! Ooh, just had it harder. Oh, just had it harder. That was right on line. Didn't want to really speed it by the hole. I mean, we're actually 13, that's as went to 14 under. At that stage, I think we'd have a 3-shot lead. So we're going steady. You've got to guarantee a carry at least 7 or 8 yards. Yeah, we can carry this wind into this hole. It cuts in 7 yards. I'm gonna club up. Come on. Come on. That's carrying the wind a little bit shy as well. From the bunker, just a little splash out on the spot. Should be an easy out from the bunker, I believe. Yeah, it was online there. Just had it a bit shy, but didn't want to really overcook it again. This one just requires a little bit of focus. Which one's put it into the bunker? 117. Right, we get a par, we stay at 2-under, 14-under for the tournament. Probably a 3-shot lead. At the moment, I think we've actually got a 2-shot lead. No, a 3-shot lead. Bushman's 11-under. I'm going to fade this a little bit, I think. Try and hold it against that wind. Oh, we've absolutely ripped this. Ball's below the feet a little. It's kind of going to go into that wind. This pin, that's a tricky pin. I'm going to club up here. Let's go with a 9-iron. Had that a bit hard as well. Probably that Fade on, it's good as well, it's holding up a little bit more. Bad. So the kind of left edge of the green there, kind of a putt at least at birdie. 7 inches down. Gotta be a little careful if it gets away on him. Not as much break as the last putt we had at this same kind of break. Roughly about there. Oh, we've hit it. Pivot, miss hit. No, I never get the break. Not even close.
Just a couple of feet.
In for par. We made it 14 under. Got a good lead in this tournament now. If you can carry 300 yards, Bay Hill always favours the longer hitter. Oh, ho, ho. Oh baby. Booyah! It's a good drive.
Catching up with the live groups, or the live golf.
A couple of holes behind now. Right. I'm actually going to play this and we hold it into the wind. Although it's not that much into the wind. Two cobs up, maybe take a bit off this. There's also a good chance that Arnold will say hello to you, look you in the eye. Best there ever was. Is that going to be length? Is it going to be good? He needs to get down a little. A bit too long. At least misread the wind. This is never going to sit down. Certainly had enough power. Just this kid's not down here. I think he's. Well, bunker play is really about technique and feel. Is he to put it in the bunker? Yeah. By the left, it's short. No, I think he's put it in the bunker. That he could open up A3 iron. That's right, A3 iron on a short bunker shot from a green. I've had it a bit hard. You can buy a good bit, yep. That's a kind of mistake there. Solid play, hard at the green. Oh, he's made a good bunker shot there. Getting ready for the putt. I really don't know what this does. Looks as if it comes right to left, but I could be wrong. You always move it another wee bit. Yeah, did we miss hit that left target? And you can see the golfer is just boiling right now after that miss and the drop shot here at the ninth. Maybe a bogey. Back to 13 under.
Here's McIlroy, he's got a birdie putt, 31 foot, misses for a tie of the lead. Ooh, no, he's missed it, and he's put it a good few feet by as well, so he's struggling for par.
Right, we could go super big in this, like, oh my goodness, this is... This might seem risky, but... Ooh! Mishit it. Put some fade on it, hopefully it comes right. Oh my goodness, hit that path. Oh, sugar, it's went over the green. Oh, 399 yards. Wow. It's big. Well, this is where we're going to see exactly how good they are. You know, that's not exactly right. The best lie, but it's sort of doable if you know what you're doing. Let's go, let's just chip this up, hopefully get it close. It's a difficult chip, to be honest. Oh, not bad, a bit shy. Good chance at birdie though. Well, maybe. Just need to get this break. I've get down low here. Yes. And we go over here. Come on, get in the hole. Not high enough.
Tough start to the backside, Frank.
Leishman's got a putt here on 17. This must be for a par. I think he's in the bunker. Yeah, he's made it. Good par save. Oh, he nearly missed that. So Leishman's 11 under, going up the last hole. Kisner and Co are 10 under, one behind.
Right, no, don't hit that. Again, this is just play. Maybe go over here. Oh, for it perfect again. That should just come off with that wind. Get it along. 350, 49. At 180, oh man, that wind is so strong. Man, we could play it safe. And I'm going to play this with a bit of safety. I'm going to add a bit of loft, maybe. Maybe hit it 106, 108. Now we've had a bit extra, which might just make it a bit more safer. No, it's way too safe.
Second shot, but still not done. A good third shot, maybe get away here with par. And setting up here in the rough.
Can we pitch in here? Can I be new? If I want to pitch is short. Oh, jeez, in the hole. That's close.
Is currently sitting at one under for the round.
Yep, and she goes. Now, Kisner's on the 17th, so we need to play catch up here at least. Again, a good shot. Just means we know what we need to score in a way. I wanted to actually be a little bit closer than this, but I've kind of mistimed it a little bit. Oh, they're struggling. He's off the back, Kisner, I think.
Could drive here from 21 yards. We might. It's going to be close.
Just accommodate for the wind here. We're 13 under par at the moment. So comfortable in the lead. Oh, that's a perfect shot. Stay. Bunker. Not far from the pin, though.
You know how to play this shot, Frank, right? You keep your chin up, you look down your nose at the ball.
There's Leishman teeing off. Keep your head still. Just gonna shove this out here. What's he done? Where's he put it? Oh, we've went too far. Oh, he's hit it into the tree. I don't know what happens if we tie. I may have to play extra holes, maybe. I don't know. Right, 4 inches up. I think there's a little bit of break, but it's not much, I don't think. Ooh, in the hole. Whew, back to 14 under. I'm going to hit a 3-wood.
So you've either got a choice to play short of that or sneak it down the end, which is about 300 yards.
Oh, we've had it full beans, but we've had it a bit of draw, so might catch that bunker. It's going way over it. That's actually not a bad play, because you're coming in more over the grass or over land than water. So here we go. Look at that wind.
think I'm going to play safe here. I'm going to actually fade this in. I'm going to play a wee bit extra. Oh, put it a bit short. Get up, get up.
So the second of the par four goes begging, and now I'll have to rely on the short game. But a short game is
a little pitch out here.
Redeem a lot of mistakes. See if he does it here.
Not bad. Nice. Stone dead. Got part. Keep us at 14 under. Par 3, 14th.
Once again, very narrow entry into the green, so
difficult hole. Pins cut on that side, so we're just going to let the wind pull it off. I'm maybe going to play this a little bit extra. Oh, we've hit that. Well, in our mind, we've had it perfect. It's drifting a little bit. There's a few people been down there today.
Set himself up for a good scoring opportunity with his second shot.
Probably I play this high lob, I think. Maybe go a bit there. Oh, I've had a bit of extra power. Yeah, it's a bit left as that. Just left edge.
That's disappointing. He misses the par.
That's the putt.
Just needs to keep it steady.
Okay. Back 13 under. Comfortably still in the lead though, because Leishman's in trouble at the 18th.
Dog leg right here. What's the best way to go, Frank? Really down the left side. It's very tempting to try and hit it across
that
fade
on this.
Not only do you have to carry the bunker, you've also got to carry those little shrubs down the right side.
Bad shot. Bit of draw on it.
Oh, I like that.
Which one's in the rough?
Long and straight. That's how you do it.
Oh, it's got a difficult shot right across that water.
Full retreat. Perfect release through the ball. This shot is on the fairway. Over 300 yards.
I'll go a 5-iron. Kind of playing quick here. I want to really catch up. Go, go! We're a little bit short. It's not bad though. Now here's Leishman going. He's going for the. He's hitting out, he's laying up. Yeah, he's played it just short.
There's
a little bit of break on this side. Not much. In the hole. Oh, too hard. Way too hard.
At least he's seen the line as it went past the hole. So just replicate that on the way back.
Can't really see this. Oh, I hate putting the shadow. It's in the hole. But it keeps us at 13. Now let's catch up here. They're just putting that out of the 17th, Kisner and Hoffman. We're getting there.
Birdies there coming home. 17, a very difficult par 3 over the water. The bunker is there. Takes an excellent shot.
Oh, baby. Bring it home. Right, Hoffman's just missed that putt. That's quite good, a bogey. Yep, Hoffman's back to 9 under par. Got a chance here of taking this. 202 yards into that window. I'm coming up a couple of times here. I don't want to be short. Well, that's going to be well. I should be well safe. Should be. Oh, it's way big. It's not bad. It's going to be in the short stuff. First cut. his Kisnet 6 foot putt. Makes it. Is that for a bogey? He's at 10 under par, Kisnet. Right, let's get this down here. Oh, you had it hard enough. Oof, jeez. Man, that was so close. Rory McIlroy, he got a bogey at the last. So is he 9 under? He's 9 under. Look at this chip. Oof. Yeah. Kinda, yeah. Par will do it. Right, we're actually just about catching up with the leaders. They're about to tee off at 18. So I kind of want to be playing the last hole with them. Right, this is definitely... I'm going to go 3 clubs down. I've drew it a little bit, might be good into that wind. Get down! Bite! Into green. Difficult pin to get. I mean, it's at the front, it's almost impossible to get it really close unless you bounce it right in the edge of that bunker. Yeah, this is more a kind of a lag putt here. Good line, good pace, might have a chance. Stop. Oh jeez. Kinda wanted to play the last set of 2 holes minimum, maybe even the last 3 holes with them, but shouldn't be a problem here, but not a formality either. Maybe just outside left edge. Oh, critical of that. Kinda make mistakes here, but we're gonna go back to 12 under. So at this moment in time, we've got a short lead over Leishman, but he's, I think he's got a putt there for a par. Right, Kisner's gonna tee off, we're at the same tee. So we'll probably let him tee off. Oh, he's hit into the rough, the left hand rough. We're probably actually going to put a bit of draw in this. Kind of semi-hold it up. Here's Hoffman. Right, he's teed off. I think he's going to find the fairway. Yep. Left-hand edge of the fairway. Right, let's tee off here. So we've actually playing... We've caught up with the live feed. Oh, our tee shots, absolutely majestic. 341 yards, up the middle. Here's Tyrrell Hatton, he's got a putt here. Tyrrell Hatton's not played well today. And he's got the putt, that's for, what's it got? 9 under par, finished with 71, not bad, he's 1 under par. I mean, he was there or thereabouts. Tied with McIlroy and Hoffman at the moment at 9 under. Kisner's at 10. Leishman. I think Leishman's got this putt to stay 11 under par. In the rough, he kind of weighed up short and he's pitched it to about. Let's see, pitched it to. Probably come up on the screen. So I'm just waiting. We're just playing a waiting game here. He's got about 5 foot, maybe. You really have to sort of change your approach to playing these holes. It looks nice out there, the blue skies, plenty of high sunshine. But he's got putt for par. Let's stay 11 under par. Does he make it? Yeah, he's made it. So Leishman is clubhouse leader at 11 under par. So we're actually one shot ahead. Yeah, So he shot 69 today, 3 under par, good score from Mark Wishman. So he's 11 under par, Kisner's a shot back at 10, and Hoffman's 9 under, so he's out of it. So Kisner's going to have to get a birdie to tie the lead. And we're sitting 12 under par, so we really need to get a par to win. But we'll just go to the overhead here. So here's Kisner. Kisner's in the left hand rough. Probably actually quite a few yards behind us. Yeah, we are right up at that. In fact, we're at the bottleneck. So we're miles ahead. Give me a drink of water. Not a bad lie. It's kind of trampled down a bit. Yeah, he's quite far back.
The plan will be to aim it at the back left bunker, hit the club right, and chase it around the hole.
What's our wind? See, our wind's completely the wrong direction. They've got a 9 mile an hour wind into the face. Mine's just behind, so it's obviously moved. Oh, he's played that into the bunker. So Kisner's probably going to have to get up. In fact, no. He can't do it. I think Wishman's won it. He's in that bunker. In fact, he's in this bunker. He's in this bunker, I think. Over here. We've actually quite a difficult shot here. I'm going to start actually getting my shot. Because obviously he's just about to hit. Hoffman's about to hit a shot. I mean, I'm thinking of going. With a. Do we go with a 56? I think we hit this about 132 and we go for the middle. We go safe. Yeah, I'm probably actually about 20 yards ahead of Hoffman. Yeah, he's hurt. Oh, what a great shot. Went for the flag, because he's got to, because he's 9 under par. Right, let's hit. Right, we're going to go. We don't really attack the pin, I don't think. I mean, we could get a bit cheeky here. I think we go a bit there. Here we go. Had a bit of a wait. We've actually gone for the pin. Get down, bait! Oh, we big. Oof, man, that was a bit of a kind of whipper. Right, I'm going to analyse my shot while they walk up to the green. So we're 12 under par, Leishman's 11. Kisner's in the bunker, he's 10 under. But he's basically... No, he's not going to win unless he chips in.
Let me have a look.
I don't know what. Siri just kicks him at silly times. Do you know this bunker shot? I think we're going to go with a high lob here. Although we could. To be honest, that wind's actually quite tricky, so...
Frank, through the years, we have
I think we want to hit a bit here.
What we would call good ball strikers, great swingers of the golf club, but there is something else that separates those kinds of players...
I may come back to that. I'm going to let them... I'm going to let them sort of hit close to the pin.
I think most players... It's always good...
So Wishman, I think, is probably more than likely got it in his world, but I'm probably going to win in my world if I can get up and down here.
So when you set foot on the first tee, you've also got to be aware of what if my driver doesn't go as well.
Right, here's Kisner. He's in that front bunker there, just at the very first one in the green there. I'm in this back bunker. The pin position's actually pretty close. Oh, he's... Oh, that's a great bunker shot. Nice. Leishman's going to win. Leishman's 11 under par. Kisner can only get a par. So I'm basically... Right, let's go. Let's hit this shot here. Oh, nice shot. Stay. This should be good. And, well, technically, the Leishman's won at 11 under par, but I've got a putt here, a tiddler for a par. 12 under par, rounds of 68, 68, 68, 72. And we win the Arnold Palmer Invitational at Bay Hill. Virtually, I suppose, but Mark Leishman has won the actual tournament. Hoffman here has got a putt. Putt for birdie, he's going to get him back to 10 under if he gets it in. Yeah, Kisner's probably easily got a putt. What's Hoffman? Oh, get in there, son. Good birdie, back to 10 under par for Hoffman. Yeah, he's done well. Not maybe the round he wanted, but 73 gets him back into tied second at the moment. Kisner's got a putt now to save par. Give him a big putt if he misses, because that means he'll go second in his own. It's a bit maybe 5.5 feet. We'll stick with this once this is all buttoned up. Now that's it. Here he goes. Usually tells you what size a putt it is. Looks about 5.5 foot at least. It's a putt for part. Oh, I guess it in. So Kisner and Hoffman 10 under par. Mark Leishman wins the Arnold Palmer Invitational at 11 under par. But we win it at 12 under par. So all in all, it's actually quite a good sort of live tournament over the weekend. We played well. Kind of struggled. I was actually speeding up to catch up with the players. I wanted to play the last, at least fill 2 holes, maybe even 3 holes, but so that's it. As I say, we win at 12 under. Mark Leishman second, 11. Kisner Hoffman at 10 under. McIlroy Hatton at 9 under. Adam Hadwin at 8. Grillo actually, he came back. He had a 4 under par round at 7 under. He done not bad. Molinari, Glover, 7 under. Tommy Fleetwood at 6 under. So, guys, that's it. Dan and Dusty, we actually did kind of virtually win it at 12 under par. One shot ahead of Mark Leishman. So, that was quite good. I quite enjoyed that. So, once again, alright, well, I did have a bit of controversy. Somebody disliked my video, so I asked the person to kind of, if somebody dislikes a video, it would be nice to give a reason. That way, if it's something that I'm doing wrong, I can constructively sort of make it better, make better videos. But somebody took a dislike that I did clickbait by using Arnold Palmer's picture in the preview JPEG. That's not clickbait. Clickbait is really falsely advertising. I was playing, and he actually said that it was clickbait and conveniently used it to cash in on the Arnold Palmer Invitational at the weekend. Well,
The whole point of this video is actually playing alongside the pros as it happens. So obviously I was going to be playing at the Arnold Palmer Invitational this weekend, because that was the whole point of the series. It wasn't quick bait. I used Arnold Palmer's picture. I actually did exactly what it said in the tin. It's meant to get people to click to watch it. That's the whole point. That's not quick bait. Quick bait is when you have like falsely advertised picture in the front, and when you go into the video, it's got nothing to do with that. That's more a quick bait thing. To me, it was just a good strategized JPEG preview, and that's what it's meant to do. It's meant to get people to click. So he didn't like it. He thought it was quick bait. He thought it was done in the wrong manner, distastefully, which I don't agree with. I think that's a great tribute to Arnold Palmer. And that is the Arnold Palmer Invitational. I mean, I'm playing in the actual tournament at Bay Hill, so everything there is not false advertising. So I just said, well, fair enough, I appreciate the comment and stuff, but I said I don't think it's quite bait. So that said and done, you'll probably not watch this video to the end anyway. But that was a bit disheartening, to be honest. You know, it's just the way it is. People just don't really see it. And I did say that I was playing virtuate at the same time as the PGA Tour event. He says, I'm trying to remember his exact comments. What was it he used? I don't want to be misquoted here. I mean, he did say, your choice in the photo appears, my opinion, intended to generate views in a less than respectful manner. Well, that's what it's meant to do, but not in a less than respectful manner. Seems oddly coincidental to post this weekend. If I'm misinterpreting, my bad. Well, I'm playing a live event with the actual event that's happening. And he says, who cares that you're playing virtually alongside the PGA event? Again, just my opinion, since you asked. So, and the top one was, how about trying to cash in with that quick bait photo coincidentally posted in the weekend of his invitational? Pathetic. I mean, it is what it is. I was playing alongside the real life tournament, and I was playing virtually. And I thought it was a good idea. I quite enjoyed playing it. I'm a golf fan through and through. And I've got every respect for Arnold Palmer. In fact, he's probably one of the best players on and off the course. Probably played before my time, but the guy was an absolute legend. And there was no disrespect meant, but people can post what they want. They've got their own opinions. To be honest, he didn't get the full idea of what I was doing. So that's it. I mean, I don't want to go on about it, but it was nice to get some feedback, comments about a dislike, but in that kind of manner, well, it just is what it is. So guys, I've kind of waffled on at the end. I just wanted to get that out of my system. So once again, if you haven't subscribed, please do so. It's greatly appreciated. And I'll continue to make videos for as long as I want. Thanks for watching, guys. See you later. Oh, by the way, we did win the Bay Hill tournament, 12 under par. Just thought I would get that in. So, well, see you later, guys. Bye.